morning children. So as I already told in the previous class that we will going to give or we will going to study one of the example for your formal letter writing. So as what the situation that we are facing, according to that it is very necessary, became a necessary to get books through the online. So I have taken the topic of e-library. So the topic is write a letter to your principal for providing e-library services. So for providing e-library services, you are requesting your principal. Okay, you are writing a letter to your principal for providing e-library services. So for what is the meaning of e-library here? Electronic library. So we can see or we can go through with the subjects and the books that are available in our school library through online itself. It is not necessary to come to the school. We can also see through the online. See, as I already told about the format of the formal letter writing, we have to mention the first sender's address, means the person who is writing the letter. We have to mention the address of that person at the first. And as I told that we have to keep all the things at the left corner only. Okay, left margin only. See, from, it is not necessary to from and to, but for your information and for understanding in a better manner, I have written here. So from ABC, ABC means your name over there. You have to write your name there. Manita Public School, Kurubara, Halli. Next, 6, your date. Date you have to mention, 6-1-2021. Next, 2, means to whom you are sending. You have to mention their address to Principal Manita Public School, Kurubara, Halli. So I am going to write to the principal of your respective school. Next, subject, requesting to provide e-library services. So I am requesting you to give permission or to provide e-library so that we can read and write well. Respected sir, so as I already told that, if you already know that the principal is sir, right? So if you don't know the person here, he or she, you have to put a slash here and put madam. So as I already, we all know that our principal is sir, so there is no need to write this. Okay, there is no need to write this. Next, respected sir, we call it as salutation. We name it as salutation. Salutation means giving a respect. With due respect and humble submission, with due respect and humble submission, to state that in this situation of pandemic, we are not able to attend the school regularly. So it is quite difficult. So as if we are not having a situation to come and sit in school as usual, because of this pandemic, we are facing problems to come to the school. To enhance our studies, I am requesting you to provide e-library. So to study more, make us busy in our studies, I am requesting you to provide e-library. So in e-library we can go through any time, so that we can indulge ourselves at any time of a day. So we can indulge ourselves in the studies at any time of the day. There is no need of, or there is no any compulsion that we have to log in at 9 only. So nothing like that, because e-library is online, so we can go through the library at any time of a day. So it is not having any compulsion in getting into the library. Your kind consideration and cooperation in this respect, your kind consideration and cooperation. So I am requesting you to consider this letter. So I am requesting on behalf of all the students of Manyata School, I am requesting to consider my request and cooperate. So I am hoping that I am going to get cooperation from you. So as we are going to clap, we have to bring the two hands together. So from students as well as from the school here, we are going to get a good results. For to take that good results, we are requesting you to cooperate. Therefore, hope and pray that you would be kind enough to take necessary steps in providing e-library for us. So we are hoping for the best. We are in a positive way that you will going to give us e-library services, as you are all kind enough. As usual, you are going to cooperate for us in all the aspects of our studies. We are hoping that this will be a great step from your side to enhance, to develop our studies. So at the last, this is about citation. This, the whole thing is about the body of the letter. Here you are telling about what is the necessary of the e-library for us, and you are telling your principal that we are hoping to the good. You are going to conclude over there. You are going a closing note or concluding note in this paragraph. And at the last, so as there is no any space here, I am going to write over here itself. Okay? Can I rub this off? I am going to rub this, and you can take care. See. Thanking you. Closing note. You was faithfully your obedience. You can be. Okay. Thanking you. Closing note. As well as your name over here. So this is one of the example I am going to give. So that now I hope you are going. You will understand what the formal letter writing is. So as I already told, formal letter writing, we are going to write to a particular person with a official purpose. It is not about any personal purpose. It is only about an official purpose. So as if the situation is pandemic and about the confinements, so I am given the subject of e-library. So e-library, it will going to help all the students to study well. It will help all the students to indulge or to be busy in our studies itself. So for all, keeping all these points in the mind, have given this as an example. So hope you all understand what is formal letter writing now, and think and try to write on your own basis with keeping this an example. This is keeping this as an example. You have to try yourself. So like write a letter to your principal requesting for the leave, write a letter to the Hindu, means the newspaper, for about any job, or writing a letter to the editor of the Deccan Herald focusing on the street light issues, writing a letter to MLA of our locality focusing on the development of our area. So you can take any topic, but it must be a formal. So it must be with a purpose. You should not write something which is not necessary, or which is like a informal. So how are you, wishing them, so nothing like that. You just go through with the direct topic. So as I have given 9 points in the formal letter writing, I'm going to say the from here. I have started with from, sender's address, date,
subject, salutation, body of the letter, conclusion and ending, signature. Yours faithfully, signature. So these are the points you have to keep it in the mind while you are writing the formal letter writing. So hope you all understand what is formal letter writing now. Let's study informal letter writing in our next class. Bye everyone, take care.